हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 808 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज द सेम दैट इज एंटी पायरेटिक एंड एनर्जेटिक ड्रग्स एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एंटी पायरेटिक एनर्जेटिक एंड आल्सो एंटी क्लॉटिंग drug that is called aspirin, acetyl salicylic acid. And the rest ones I am going to discuss today, that is phenacetine, novalgine, paracetamol, pinadol. They are all interlinked, and phenacetine was very useful drug against temperature, to reduce the temperature, that is antipyretic and analgesic drug. Up to 1978, it was widely used with different combinations, that is phenacetine. And this phenacetine, once they started abusing, overuse causes some kidney damage and kidney disease. So in the first British, UK banned this phenacetine, analgesic antipyretic capsule, and this capsule was coming in 150 and 300 mg. Then in 1983 it was banned by USA government, and today we are not using it because of this complaint. Novalgine group is also the same antipyretic, analgesic, and these drugs are used with combinations like with aspirin, with caffeine, and also some percentage of paracetamol. So these drugs are widely used, Novalgine group, to treat common cold and fever, muscular pain, rheumatoid arthritis, all which are related to your pain and temperature. So this is your medicinal importance of phenacetine and novalgine and paracetamol. So this is your aniline, and once it is treated with potassium hydroxide in presence of H2SO4, it is changed into phenolic. And then finally, when it is treated with ethyl bromide, it is converted into phenacetine. Actually, phenacetine is the derivative of aminophenol, and this aminophenol is produced in our body when acetamide is oxidized. When oxidation takes place, this aminophenol is produced, and this aminophenol itself is antipyretic, and that's why from aminophenol the acetylation has done, and with that substituent it is called that is your phenacetine, and its formula is C10H13NO2. The second one, that is novalgine, is also analgesic, antipyretic, and it is used in combination with aspirin and sometimes some percentage of caffeine. And it is we can start it from aminoantipyrene, and this aminoantipyrene is finally converted into, first it is mobiline, and this mobiline itself is used as analgesic and antipyretic. So here I am giving the detail about phenacetine, and after that I will be discussing the novalgine. Actually, novalgine is synthesized starting from aminoantipyrene, and from aminoantipyrene we are getting melubrine. Melubrine itself is widely used as an antipyretic agent, and from melubrine it is converted into novel gene. So first that is phenacetin, and the other name of phenacetin is paramethoxyesterlide. And that paramethoxy, at para position there is methoxy group, and that is your esterlide, that is called phenacetin, and its molecular formula is C13, S16, N3, Na, O4, S. Number one, the oxidation of esterlide in the body. In our body, once the oxidation takes place of esterlide, we get para-aminophenol, led to the use of para-aminophenol derivative. And once this para-aminophenol is produced and its derivative, that is actually antipyretic and analgesic. Derivatives as antipyretic. Nowadays, substituted para-aminophenol are widely used as antipyretic. The phenacetin is one of the most important substituted para-aminophenol. So actually, phenacetin is one of the most important substituted product of para-aminophenol derivative. And that is known as para-amino antipyretic substituted. And the ethyl ether of aminophenols, the ethyl ether of aminophenol is known as phenetidines. And this phenetidines, once it is subjected to acetylation, so the acetyl derivative of phenetidine is known as phenacetin. So phenacetin is the acetyl derivative of phenetidine, and the phenacetin is the substituent of para-aminophenol derivative. So, in continuation, that is about the phenacetin. Actually, phenacetin was very, very popular drug, that is analgesic drug, to reduce the pain, different type of pain, means muscular pain, headache, toothache, rheumatoid arthritis, osteoarthritis pains, and it was known as very popular pain killer. And it was given in different combinations with the caffeine, and also with paracetamol, even with aspirin. But when it was found that it is damaging the kidney, then worldwide people started withdrawing it from market. First in 1978, UK withdrew phenacetin from market, and then in 1983 USA. But still in combinations people are using. So number two, phenacetin was used as anti-analgesic and fever reducing drug in both human and veterinary medicine. Also it was used in veterinary medicine for animals medicine for many years. It was introduced in the therapy in the year 1887 and was extensively used in analgesic mixtures until it was implicated in kidney disease and damage by its overuse and abuse. Number three, phenacetin was once used as stabilizer for hydrogen peroxide to stabilize the hair, bleaching preparation. Phenacetin 150 to 300 mg capsule was sold with common combination. Sometimes in combination it was sold with 230 mg aspirin plus 150 mg phenacetin and 30 mg of caffeine. This combination, mixture of these three, was very popular because this combination was very effective. But in 1978, phenacetine, a combination was withdrawn in UK from market, and in 1983, it was withdrawn from USA market because of its toxic effect or damaging effect to kidney. Next one is, that is number four, Novalgene. Novalgene is still it is in use, and it is very good mild analgesic. Novalgene is the most widely used analgesic. Is the N-methyl derivative of Amilubrine. Actually, Amilubrine also very good analgesic, but once Amilubrine is treated with sodium formaldehyde bisulfite, then that antipyridine, amino antipyridine is converted into Novalgene. So the Novalgene is most widely used analgesic, is the N-methyl derivative of Amilubrine. And Novalgene has twice the activity of Amilubrine and least toxicity. Amilubrine can be prepared by the action of sodium formaldehyde bisulfite on amino antipyridine, and then it is finally converted into Novalgene. So the next one is that is non-steroidal and non-neurotic painkiller, or we can say antipyretic analgesic, is known as paracetamol and Panadol. Paracetamol is very common and it is widely used to treat pain and also to bring down the temperature in cold, rheumatic pain, osteoarthritis, back pain, muscular pain. I mean, for different type of pain, it is used. And once it is available in combination with aspirin and caffeine, then it is called Panadol. And the role of the Panadol is the same like paracetamol. The only difference is that it contains some percentage of aspirin, and in some cases some little 30 mg to 20 mg caffeine is also added. That is called Panadol. So the paracetamol, the structure is given here. That is one aromatic benzene ring with one phenolic group, and then NH group is there, and one methyl group with keto, and that is called paracetamol. And its molecular formula is C8H9NO2. Paracetamol is common painkiller used to treat HS and pain. It can also be used to reduce high temperature. Means if you have 102 to 103 degree Fahrenheit temperature, it can reduce, bring down to normal temperature, 97, 98 degree Fahrenheit. And number six, paracetamol is also known as estaminophen. So this estaminophen, I mean, estamino means this is a style group, it is amino group, and it is phenyl group. This is phenyl group, this is acetyl group, this is amino group. That's why it is also known as estaminophen, and is a medication used to treat pain and fever. It is typically used to treat mild and moderate pain relief. Paracetamol in combination of aspirin and caffeine is known as Panadol. And Panadol, it is used for the relief of pain from conditions such as muscular pain. Panadol is also used for headache, cold, influenza, backache, period pain, in osteoarthritis and toothache, and rheumatic pain. So with this your chapter of analgesic and antipyretic drug, which are non-steroidal and non-narcotic, is over. I have already discussed the very important ones like aspirin, paracetamol, panadol, phenacetin, and these drugs are very much used to treat the patient who are suffering from pain and fever, high temperature. So with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.